Joining us to talk about all things going on around the National Hockey League, NHL Network insider Chris Johnston. And Chris, let's start with Patrik Berglund, because this is a very strange story, to say the least. The Sabres have put him on unconditional waivers for the purpose of terminating his contract. What do you know about this one?
Well, I would almost go so far, EJ, as to call this unprecedented, because in Patrik Berglund, you have a player that was owed about $12.5 million still on his deal with the Buffalo Sabres. And so for this to happen, I mean, there's not a lot of comparables to be drawn here. And I think, you know, what's important in this case is what we don't know. We don't know what Patrik Berglund's thinking. We don't know what his agent intends. We don't know if he intends to grieve this process. And we don't know if he wants to play in the National Hockey League again. And so until we have some of those questions answered, there's going to be a shroud of mystery around this one. But, you know, what we do know is that he missed the team flight on Friday to Washington. The Sabres suspended him, and now they intend to terminate his deal. So, you know, I suspect this isn't the last we've heard of this, but, you know, for a pretty high-profile case, there's a lot that we still don't know.
Chris, what can you tell us about his circumstance with his no-trade clause, that he had a limited no-trade, apparently, in St. Louis? There was a list of teams. What do you know about that part of the story? Because that plays into this.
Absolutely. You know, he wasn't too happy to be sent to the Buffalo Sabres. I think it's fair to state that, EJ. And so going back to last season, he actually had a full no-trade clause with the St. Louis Blues that ran through June 30th. On July 1st, that converted to a 20-team no-trade clause. And for whatever reason, it's believed he didn't get that 20-team no-trade clause submitted, you know, the teams that were on that list. And the deal was made, the Ryan O'Reilly trade, on July 1st, sending him to Buffalo. And, you know, I don't think it's a place he was happy to arrive in initially. And certainly when he got there, he had a fairly limited role with the Sabres this season.
All right, let's talk about the holiday roster freeze. That starts tonight. For fans out there, give them the background of how this works.
Well, we're not going to see any trades, at least unless some GMs are, you know, on the clock right now in the final 5 hours or so before the roster freeze kicks in. And, you know, it's pretty unique. It's something the NHL does that you don't see other sports league do, and that, you know, after tonight and until December 28th, there will only be limited player movement around the league. You can see the odd player brought up or down from the minors depending on needs for specific teams, but there's no waiver activity. And as I mentioned, no trades that can be made over the holiday period. So I think it's something that's nice for the players, you know, certainly guarantees them a little bit of stability in a pretty uncertain profession at a time of year, you know, meant to be spent with families and you know, doing nice things. And so, you know, as of tonight, the action, the subplots about the sport will be on pause at least until December 28th.
Vegas Golden Knights made some news. They put Max Pacioretty on the IR. What's the latest with his health?
Well, we're still waiting for an official update. There's a little bit, actually, of mystery around this injury. You know, Max Pacioretty missed a game last week with what the team called a minor injury in New Jersey, returned after that and played a couple games, but was re-injured earlier this week. And you know, there's not a lot of clarity on what exactly Max Pacioretty's dealing with and the timeline on his return. But, you know, in the meantime here, they brought up Brandon Peary from the American Hockey League. He's been having a great season down there at the Chicago Wolves. And, you know, at some point we expect the Golden Knights to officially update this situation. But, you know, waiting to hear, because Max Pacioretty's been a huge part of their success the last little bit. And, you know, appears he's going to be out for a little while.
All right, Chris, thanks for your time today. We really appreciate it. And enjoy the games tonight.
Thank you, EJ. You too.